Good morning and a very warm welcome to Dundonald Parish Church. My name is Lynsey Brennan and I'm the minister here at Dundonald. And it is my pleasure to welcome you to worship this morning when we'll be thinking about compassion is action and looking to the life of Jesus. So welcome everybody, whether you're worshipping with us for the first time or whether you are new to worshipping in this space. You are all welcome together. If you're new to online worship here in Dundonald, just a reminder that we have our own YouTube channel. So if you go to YouTube and type in Dundonald Parish Church, you will see all of our services from over the last couple of months. And you can go back and you can look at them at any time that you want. And there's also some thoughts for the day, and there's also a couple of interviews that might be of interest to you as I interview people of faith and talk about different topics. So do look at our channel, our Facebook page, and see what other things that we have to offer to enhance your worship and also to bring you closer into a loving relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. But we welcome you today. If you were here last week, you wouldn't have seen me. You would have seen Martin Fair, who is the moderator of the Church of Scotland. He very kindly gave us a service to use while I was on holiday last week. Now, the next week I'm on holiday again. I'm taking the second week of my summer leave. So next week you won't have me again, and Martin Fair has kindly given us another service that we can use. So we thank Martin for his time and bringing us worship next week. Next week, if you need any emergency pastoral cover, any questions, anything that is an emergency, then Christina Stewart will be covering for me. But any church matters should go to Bob Stewart, our session clerk. Just one more intimation before we start our time of worship. We are currently thinking about what church is going to look like when we go back into our church buildings. We don't know when this is likely to be. It is unlikely going to be in phase three because we can't use our balcony and we can't sing and we have to use PPE, which really limits the numbers that we can get into our building. It could only be roughly about 20 with the 2 metre distance. So when we go back into our church buildings, likely in phase four, what we want to do is to be able to live stream our services so that we can keep on our online presence, which is really, really important. Now that we are online and now that we are able to make worship accessible to all people, we need to keep that going. So what I'm looking for is a techie team, people that are interested in live streaming and using equipment and computers. Please get in touch with myself and Bob Stewart because we need to grow our worship team so we can move our church forward and to be able to serve in this new era that we're going to be in soon. But that's all. Let's now come to God. Let's have a call to worship. Welcome to the worship of the Lord Jesus Christ. We have come to worship the Lord. To those who are hungry, Jesus says, come and eat, there's more than enough for all. To those who are thirsty, he says, come and drink, it's free for the taking. Stop wasting your money on food that doesn't satisfy. Come to me and you will find everything you need. Let's worship God as we sing our first hymn, I Heard the Voice of Jesus Say.
So weary. quenched, my soul revived, and now I live in Him. I heard the voice of Jesus say, I am this dark world's light. Look unto me, my morn shall rise, and all thy day be bright. I look to Jesus, and I found in Him my star, my sun. And in that light of life, I'll walk till traveling days are done.
Let's come now together to approach God in prayer. Let us pray. Mighty God of miracles, we come before you. We imagine what it might have been like, part of a crowd of 5,000. There may be far fewer of us here online, but we think about the people in other churches in our country also worshipping you in this way. Distant still from each other, but bound together by your great love. We gather in spirit to meet with you, Jesus. And here is now, as we confess to you ways we have walked away from your grace and love. And please join me when you see a line of prayer on the screen. Sometimes, Lord, we know we don't listen properly to you. We're easily distracted, or we listen but still go our own way, putting ourselves first. Forgiven by you, we can start anew. Sometimes, Lord, we don't trust you to meet our needs, to take care of us, to feed us with food, both spiritual and physical. Forgiven by you, we can start anew. Sometimes, Lord, we're anything but prepared for our journey with you. Forgiven by you, we can start anew. Sometimes, Lord, we look for our own ways out of a situation instead of seeking and trusting you. Forgiven by you, we can start anew. Lord God of compassion and boundless blessings, we are full of amazement that you care so greatly for the needs of your people. We worship and adore you for your generosity, your love, and your power. Lord, we know you look deep inside us, seeing not only our outer, but our inner needs. Have compassion on us, we pray. Feed us today from your holy word, and we will be filled. And hear us now as we come together to say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory for ever. Amen. Our Bible will be read today by Catherine Murdoch.
Good morning. The first Bible reading this morning comes from Isaiah 55, and it's verses 1 to 5. Is anyone thirsty? Come and drink, even if you have no money. Come, take your choice of wine or milk. It's all free. Why spend your money on food that does not give you strength? Why pay for food that does you no good? Listen to me, and you will eat what is good. You will enjoy the finest food. Come to me with your ears wide open. Listen, and you will find life. I will make an everlasting covenant with you. I will give you all the unfailing love I promised to David. See how I used him to display my power among the peoples. I made him a leader among the nations. You also will command nations you do not know, and peoples unknown to you will come running to obey, because I, the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, have made you glorious. And the second reading today comes from Matthew 14, and it's verses 13 to 21. As soon as Jesus heard the news, he left in a boat to a remote area to be alone. But the crowds heard where he was headed and followed on foot from many towns. Jesus saw the huge crowd as he stepped from the boat, and he had compassion on them and healed their sick. That evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a remote place and it's already getting late. Send the crowds away so they can go to the villages and buy food for themselves." But Jesus said, "That isn't necessary. You feed them." "But we only have 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish, they answered. "Bring them here," he said. Then he told the people to sit down on the grass. Jesus took the 5 loaves and 2 fish, looked up toward heaven and blessed them. Then, breaking the loaves into pieces, he gave the bread to the disciples, who distributed it to the people. They all ate as much as they wanted, and afterward the disciples picked up 12 baskets of leftovers. About 5,000 men were fed that day, in addition to all the women and children. Thanks be to God.
Pray before God. Lord Jesus Christ, by the power of your presence, open the mind of God to us, that in your light we may see the light, and in your strength be made strong. God of compassion, prepare our hearts to hear your word today. Amen. So if I said the word compassion to you, what immediately comes to mind? Is compassion just a deep feeling of concern towards another person? Or is it more than that? Is it a sign of compassion that we get upset seeing someone else being mistreated? Or is it that constant roller coaster of emotions that we experience as we watch the news at night? When we see people in third world countries in dire poverty, when we watch the suffering of children starving and affected by diseases that could be preventable. Maybe compassion is that sinking feeling deep down in the depths of your stomach when you watch the news, the Scottish news, and you see the people in our own country that have been affected by the coronavirus. I would guess that we've all had that feeling at one time or another, that feeling that our very insides are churning at the reality that something terrible is happening to somebody else. So is being a compassionate person all about feelings? I don't think so, because when we look to Jesus, we don't just hear about his feelings. We don't just hear about his feelings, we hear about the action that he took towards other people. Compassion is action. We read often in the Gospels that Jesus was filled with or had compassion on others, and then he would do some pretty amazing things. He had compassion on others and then he did something. He healed the sick, he ministered to the outcasts, he taught the poor and led people into the kingdom of God where true rest could be found. He didn't just have a feeling and then do nothing. Jesus had compassion for people and then he moved to action. Compassion is action. The word for compassion in Greek doesn't mean just a feeling of sadness for someone's situation. It means to be moved with compassion. It is to recognise the suffering of others and then to take action to help. When Jesus felt compassion, he moved. He didn't wait, he didn't think about it, he acted. And we can see this today from the story in the Gospel of Matthew that we hear in verse 14. When Jesus landed and he saw a large crowd, he had compassion on them and he healed their sick. Jesus had deep compassion and moved to action to heal the sick. And he was moved to action despite the fact that his intention was actually to be alone, to seek solace in the wilderness. He was trying to process the news that his dear friend and cousin and colleague John the Baptist had been killed. He was seeking solace to be alone with his disciples, but the crowds had followed Jesus, and his response was not to meet his own needs, but to meet the needs of the crowd. The crowds were making it impossible for Jesus to have some time away in solitude with his disciples. How would you have acted if this was you? You've suddenly lost someone very close, someone very dear to you. You were trying to have space away, alone, but crowds of people descended on you and wanted something from you. Jesus' reaction here is even more remarkable. He has lost John, his cousin, his colleague. He has lost him in a manner which must have warned Jesus of what lay ahead for him. Yet when he slips away to be quiet and alone and the crowds discover him, his reaction is not anger or frustration, but compassion. He translates his sorrow over John and perhaps his sorrow over himself into sorrow for them. Jesus transforms his feelings into love for those in need. This is contrasted by how the disciples react. They ask Jesus to send the people away, for it's getting late, they're in a remote place, and the people needed to buy themselves some food. Maybe on some level the disciples were actually thinking about the needs of the crowds by asking Jesus to send them away so that they can get food. But Jesus challenges disciples to meet the crowd's need for food. The disciples object and say, look, we barely have enough food to meet our own needs. So Jesus feeds the crowds so the disciples will learn what compassion looks like. showing compassion for the crowd was maybe not the number one concern of the disciples. And how natural it would have been for Jesus just to react in the same way. He's just lost his friend. The normal reaction would be to say, could they not just leave me alone for an hour? But Jesus does not show any irritation on the crowds and shows only compassion. That was the effect a crowd of people always had on Jesus. As we read later in the Gospel of Matthew, when he saw the crowds, he had compassion on them because they were harassed and helpless like sheep without a shepherd. Jesus saw a crowd not through the eyes of one who counted life dear to himself, concerned for his own comfort and plans, but through the eyes of one who came to seek and to save those who were lost. We can't really observe this response of Jesus to the crowd without asking ourselves this question. What comes naturally to us? Irritation or compassion? It's so easy to lose patience with people when they get in our way, when they block our plans or fail to live up to our standards. It's easy to react with irritation and annoyance. And I know I am very guilty of this myself. But the good news is, with Jesus' help, we too can show compassion to others. Jesus will and can use whatever little we have in supernatural ways beyond our understanding and imagining to minister to the needs of others. We just need to be willing to offer up what we have. I read this the other day. Jesus takes ideas, loaves and fishes, money, a sense of humour, time, energy, talents, love, artistic gifts, skills with words, quickness of eye or finger, whatever we have to offer. He holds them before his Father with prayer and blessing, then breaking them so that they are ready for use, he gives them back to us to give to those who need him. Jesus can help us show his level of compassion to others. We just need to be willing to move. If we read the Gospels, we see that Jesus, moved with compassion, was led to heal the sick, feed the hungry, open eyes of the blind, teach and resurrect the dead. He was then moved to go to the cross as an ultimate act of compassion towards humanity in need of a saviour and of a redeemer. Compassion in action. We need to remember the times that Jesus has moved in our own lives so that we can respond with a heart of compassion towards someone else's need. Compassion means taking action. And we see such a beautiful display of compassion throughout the life of Jesus. And in fact, his death and resurrection was an action that he took out of compassion for us, an act of compassion so that each and every one of us could come into a loving relationship with God. But staying close to Jesus does involve effort on our behalf. It involves being mindful of reading God's word, of taking time out in prayer to stay in communication with God. And this is necessary to keep our relationship healthy and alive with God. But when we stay close to God, it is then we can be birthed afresh in his amazing compassion. We're coming into some very difficult and challenging days in the weeks and months ahead as we come out of lockdown and resume some sort of normality. For some people are coming out of lockdown and they are struggling. They're coming out of lockdown and they're suffering with anxiety, with depression, with fear. They are coming out and not knowing what the future is going to be looking like. These people need the compassion of God. And are we willing to be used by God to show compassion to other people? Are you willing to allow God to fill you with his compassion so that you can take action in his name. God is calling each and every one of us to be compassion in action and to be blessed by giving, receiving and sharing our time and talents, words and wisdom and resources with other people. So let's draw close to God through Jesus to feel his love, experience his compassion and to be birthed afresh in the compassion of God. Let's pray. Lord, a new week lies ahead of us and we don't really know what it will bring. Help us to be aware of people around us who are struggling in any way. May we be sensitive to their needs and seek your wisdom as we come alongside them. We want to be there for them, Lord, bearing your blessing. So birth us afresh today in the compassion of God. Amen.
God of compassion, we know that you look on us with the same eyes you did to those 5,000 people back then. You look on us and you have compassion. And with that compassion, you're moved to help us too. You know we need your love, your grace, your forgiveness and your strength today. Living Jesus, we reach out to you and we ask for your help to lift the many burdens we're experiencing in life right now. Help us to be birthed afresh in your compassion, so we can be compassionate to others. Compassionate God, you have compassion enough for all. Lord, in your mercy, have compassion on us. Jesus, out of your compassion for us, you invite us to come away with you to a place of rest and quiet. Help us to say yes, and then to be able to come away with you. Lord, in your mercy, have compassion for us. Lord, out of your compassion, you care for those who are harassed, helpless and lost. Sometimes we feel that way ourselves. Lord, in your mercy, have compassion for us. Lord, in your compassion, teach us to follow you, to trust you, to love you, and to love as you love. Lord, in your compassion, feed us who are hungry, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. Lord, in your compassion, heal us in the places we need healed. Lord, in your mercy, have compassion for us. And Lord, in your having compassion for us, teach us to have compassion for others as you do. Help us to show compassion in action the way you did, and remind us when it's time to come away with you for quiet and rest. Lord, in your mercy, have compassion for us. God, you are our creator and sustainer. When you open your hand, you satisfy the hunger and thirst of every living thing. And so we look to you whenever we are in need, trusting in your love and your abundant goodness. As you once fed the hungry crowds with 5 loaves and 2 small fish, we ask that you would again fill those who are empty this day. Pour out your spirit on all who hunger and thirst. We pray for those who are physically hungry, whose stomachs are empty. We think especially of the people in Somalia, Yemen, and Eastern Africa who are facing critical food shortages, who are suffering the effects of malnutrition and starvation, and watching helplessly as loved ones die. Lord, in your mercy, open your hand, pour out your spirit so that they may be filled. We pray for those who are empty emotionally, who are lonely and long for companionship and love, who are caught in the grip of depression or overwhelmed with grief. Lord, in your mercy, open your hand, pour out your spirit so that they may be filled. We pray for those who are spiritually empty, who are troubled but don't know where to turn, who long for purpose and meaning but don't know where to look, who need you but do not yet know you. Lord, in your mercy, open your hand, pour out your spirit so that they may be filled. God, we praise you for your abundant gifts in our lives. Pour out your spirit on us as well. Fill us with your compassion and love so that we would willingly share some of our abundance with those who have need. Lord, in your mercy, open your hand. Pour out your spirit so that we may be filled. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ, who came so that all of humanity might come to know the abundant life that comes from you. Amen.
Blessed are you.
And may God bless you with every gift needed for his work. May the Spirit grant you the willingness to reach out in compassion. And may the love and the compassion and the hope and the faith of Jesus dwell within you, both now and forevermore. Amen.